Welcome to our channel. If you not subscribe to our channel, subscribe to our channel. Click up the bell button to get notified about latest videos. Today in this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the meanings of microbial control methods. So for example, sterilization, disinfection, decontamination, antibiotic, antiseptic, sanitation, etc., etc. Many people confuse these terms to a greater extent, and many people think even all these terms are the same meaning, but the exact meaning of these terms are different entirely. In this video, we'll be explaining about the meanings of each and every term so that you can have a better knowledge. And so don't skip this video, watch the video till this end to get a better knowledge. Before moving into the main concept of the video, I would like to inform my dear subscribers and viewers that you can join our WhatsApp group for instant doubt clearance. Your doubts will be cleared within a stipulated time of 24 hours from the time of posting your doubt. And you can join our Facebook group to get information about webinar all over India and worldwide. Both the link of WhatsApp group and Facebook group is in the description below. Click over it to join us. And now let us get into the main concept of the video. The first term we are going to discuss is sterilization. So sterilization, it is the process by which all living cells, spores and acellular entities are either destroyed or removed from an object or habitat. While going through the definition, some people may get doubt that what are spores and what are acellular entities. Spores are nothing but the resistive form of bacteria. Whenever the bacteria is facing an unfavorable situation, it will be converted into a spore form, and this spore form cannot be easily destructed. It needs a tedious process for the complete destruction of spores. And acellular entities, the best example is viruses, because viruses does not have a proper cellular organization. In fact, they have no cellular organization, and they are considered to be non-living organisms when they are present outside the host. So now we are clear with what is spore and what is acellular entities. So basically, the sterilization will make sure that all the microorganisms, spores and acellular entities are completely destroyed in the object which is being sterilized. This sterilization process is widely used in medical industry and laboratories. In case of medical industry, sterilization process is used to clean the surgical equipments, and in case of laboratories, it is used to sterilize equipments. And next we have the term disinfection. So disinfection, it is the killing or inhibition or removal of microorganisms that may cause disease. The primary goal of disinfection is to destroy potential pathogens, but disinfection also substantially reduces the total microbial population. So the process of disinfection is accomplished with an agent called as disinfectant. This disinfectant will reduce the microbial population to a greater extent, and the main role of the disinfectant is to kill or inhibit or removal of the harmful pathogens present in the object which is being disinfected. Mostly disinfectants are used to clean inanimate objects, that is non-living objects, in simple context, for example floor, tables, chairs, etc., etc. So that's all about disinfection. Now let us discuss about sanitation. So sanitation is very much closely related to disinfection. In sanitation, the microbial population is reduced to levels that are considered safe by public health standards. So what is the difference between sanitation and disinfection? In case of sanitation also, the microbial population will be reduced, but it will make sure that the microbial population are reduced to an extent which is considered safe by the public health standards. So that's all about sanitation. Till now we have seen the microbial control methods for inanimate objects, that is the objects which are considered to be non-living. But now we'll discuss about the microbial control method in living organisms. So the best example is antiseptic. So this antiseptic is nothing but the chemical agents applied to a tissue to prevent infection by killing or inhibiting the pathogen growth. They also reduce the total microbial population because they must not destroy too much host tissue. Antiseptics are generally less toxic compared to that of the disinfectants. So these antiseptics are applied over living tissues to control or reduce the microbial population, and also this antiseptic will not affect the host tissue to a greater extent. And examples of antiseptic are Dettol, etc., etc. So that's all about the antiseptic. Now let us discuss about antibiotics and chemotherapy. So antibiotic is nothing but a chemical substance which is secreted by a microorganism which can inhibit the growth of another microorganism. Antibiotics are chemicals which are used as a defense mechanism by some microorganism against another microorganism. Alexander Fleming identified this concept applied in case of the microbial world and gave this wonderful antibiotics to the human world. The best examples of antibiotics are erythromycin, streptomycin, tetracycline, amoxicillin and penicillin, the first antibiotic, etc., etc. Next we have the chemotherapy. So it is a chemical agent used to kill or inhibit the growth of microorganism within the host cell. So the chemotherapeutic drugs are given to the patients affected with the microorganism, and this chemotherapeutic agents will be consumed by the patient and it will kill the microorganism present inside the host organism. So that's all about the chemotherapeutic agents, and this chemotherapeutic agents also has some side effects. Next, let us discuss about decontamination. It is the process of cleansing an object or substance to remove contaminants such as microorganisms or hazardous materials including chemicals, radioactive substances and infectious diseases. So this decontamination is a broad term which can remove unwanted chemical substances, unwanted radioactive substances and infectious disease causing microorganisms in an environment in which decontamination is done. So that's all about today's video. If you like the video, share and like our video, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.